Welcome to the Knox video training series. In this video, we'll show you how to connect Knox E-FOTA to VMWare Workspace ONE and add device groups from Workspace ONE. This lets you keep device information synchronized between the two. Let's get started. Before you start connecting Knox E-FOTA to VMWare Workspace ONE, you first need to create a Samsung Knox account at samsungknox.com, apply for access to Knox E-FOTA and Workspace ONE, obtain trial or commercial licenses for Knox E-FOTA and Workspace ONE, and finally, prepare your Samsung devices in Workspace ONE by enrolling them and adding them to device groups. To connect Knox E-FOTA to VMWare Workspace ONE, you'll need to create an API client in your Workspace ONE admin portal, connect to Workspace ONE through the Knox E-FOTA admin portal using your new API client's REST API key, enroll your Workspace ONE device group in Knox E-FOTA, and install the Knox E-FOTA ONE app on the devices through Workspace ONE and Knox Service plugin. To create an API client, log into the VMWare Workspace ONE admin portal. Go to Groups and Settings, All Settings. Under System, click Advanced, API, REST API. In the General tab, ensure that API access is enabled. Then click Add. Under Service, enter a unique name for the API key. Click Save. Take note of your new client's REST API key. You'll use it with Knox E-FOTA. Now that you've created an API client key, you can use it to connect Knox E-FOTA to Workspace ONE. Launch the Knox E-FOTA admin portal. In the left navigation, select EMM groups. Then, in the upper right portion of the screen, click Connect EMM. In the Pick Your EMM to Manage Devices menu, select VMWare Workspace ONE. Enter your Workspace ONE username and password. Then, enter the URL of your Workspace ONE admin portal, followed by /API/MDM. Enter your new REST API key. Then, click Connect. The smart groups from Workspace ONE are loaded. In the Add Device Groups to E-FOTA screen, turn on Sync next to the device groups that you want to add to Knox E-FOTA. For this demonstration, we'll add only one device group, but you can add multiple groups at a time. Then click Add E-FOTA Groups. The device group will be added to Knox E-FOTA with all device details synced from your Workspace ONE account. Next, you need to enroll the device group you added. In your Knox E-FOTA admin portal, on the EMM Groups tab, select the device group you want to enroll. Then, in the upper right portion of the screen, click Actions and select Enroll Devices in Groups. Select the license you want to use and click Done. Each device in the device group consumes one license seat. Enrollment will only start once you've installed the Knox E-FOTA app on the devices. The Knox Deployment Program enables frictionless out-of-the-box device enrollment and configuration for enterprises. With their existing fleet, the Knox Service plugin helps you set up your compatible UEM. Hence, we'll show you how to install and launch the Knox E-FOTA app via Knox Service plugin. Visit the Knox E-FOTA ONE admin guide to learn more about other ways to install the Knox E-FOTA app. Here, we'll show you how to add the E-FOTA app through Manage Google Play. First, you need to integrate your Workspace ONE with Android Enterprise. In your Workspace ONE admin portal, click Apps and Books, Public. Then, click Add Application. In the Add Application screen, next to Platform, select Android and ensure that Source is set to Search App Store. Next to Name, enter Knox E-FOTA. Then, click Next. In the Next screen, select Knox E-FOTA ONE. Then, under Approval Settings, select the Keep Approved When App Request New Permission. Click Done, and then click OK to confirm your request. In the next screen, next to Categories, select Business System. Click Save and Assign. In the Assignment screen, add a name for your app assignment. Choose a group to assign to the Knox E-FOTA app. This group should match the device group you added to Knox E-FOTA. Ensure that the app delivery method is set to auto. Then click Create. In the next screen, click Save. Then click Publish. Next, you need to add the Knox Service Plugin app. In your Workspace ONE admin portal, click Apps and Books, Public. Then click Add Application. In the Add Application screen, next to Platform, select Android and ensure that Source is set to Search App Store. Next to Name, enter Knox Service Plugin. Then click Next. In the next screen, select Knox Service Plugin. In the Knox Service Plugin page, click Approve. A pop-up shows the permissions for the Knox Service Plugin app. Click Approve. Then select how you would like the approval settings to be handled, and click Done. In the next screen, next to Categories, select Business System. Click Save and Assign. In the Assignment screen, add a name for your app assignment. Choose a group to assign the Knox Service Plugin app to. This group should match the device group you added to Knox E-FOTA. Ensure that the app delivery method is set to auto. Then, go to the Application Configuration tab. In the Application Configuration screen, turn on Managed Access and Send Configuration. Then scroll to Device-Wide Policies and click Configure. Expand Firmware Update FOTA Policy. Then enable Firmware Controls. Scroll to Enable E-FOTA Client Installation and Launch and enable it as well. Click Create. In the next screen, click Save. Then click Publish. Once installation is complete, the devices will be enrolled in Knox E-FOTA. You can then use Knox E-FOTA to create a campaign and assign it to the device group. This concludes our demo on how to connect Knox E-FOTA to VMware Workspace ONE. For more information on Knox E-FOTA, visit docs.samsungknox.com. Thanks for watching.